Hey YouTube, Campervan Kevin here, and I am still at Quartzsite, Arizona. You may remember when I pulled in here, I said I made almost like 3,000 miles and didn't have any trouble other than my air conditioner switch not cutting on my air conditioner compressor and my toilet leaking. Well, while here, I ran into a real nice fella that said he would help me. Well, actually, he said he would do it for me. Change the, what's this thing called? The toilet valve?
Water valve.
The water valve in my toilet. And I said, well, I really appreciate that, but if you do it for me, I won't learn how to do it. So this is Mr. Jeff.
Howdy.
He's a rv'r out here at Quartzsite, and he's going to try to teach an old dog new tricks. So hang on and stay tuned.
Later.
The first thing that I'm going to have to do, my toilet bolts are 1/2 inch. And the toilet bolts set on the side here. And on the other side there. So let me get to getting those loose. Okay, Jeff, I got both bolts. I got the toilet bolts up. What now?
Now we're going to lift the bowl up off of there.
So you say.
Careful now. You still got lines in the back. You just want to lift it up enough and bring it ahead a little bit.
Now what I'm going to do is going to wrap this towel around the back of the toilet. And there's a wing nut. What I'm going to be feeling back here is the water line that goes up to this piece right here. That's what I'm going to disconnect. Okay, now I'm reaching for the wing nut. This is the water supply line here, everybody. Sorry for the shaking. Okay, I got it. Now the toilet should lift up.
Mm-hmm. Take it right outside.
Morning, Tuck. Okay, Jeff, we got the toilet off. We got a table to sit on. Tell me what we're going to do.
This is the valve right here we're going to take off. We're going to start by taking these screws out.
Okay.
You see them there?
Yes, sir.
And then we're going to try to pull this down off. There's linkage up in here that possibly sometimes I've been able to wiggle this off the linkage. Other times we have to take this cover off to get to the linkage.
All right. Well, let's get started. So I've got this loose. Now what, Jeff?
Well, we're going to see if we can pull this out. There's a rubber O-ring on that. Just like that.
I got you.
Now you got the water. And see right here? This is the linkage I spoke of. And we've got to get it up off that linkage.
All right. I'm going to film since you already got your hands here.
Just like that.
Gotcha.
There's your valve.
Now, the reason that I think this valve was going bad is because the wall behind my toilet was wet half the way up. And this valve can let loose a tremendous amount of water, right?
This is where your main water line, water pressure is coming in. This is your feed line right here that you took off earlier. And these are very common that these things leak. It's nothing unusual.
What causes it to fail? The O-rings? Age?
I really couldn't tell you. Probably just age.
I got you. And different pressures if you don't run
a
regulator valve.
If you don't run
a
regulator, you get a lot of pressure. These ain't going to take a whole lot of pressure.
All right. I was able to buy this in town. It looks different. I was able to buy this in town.
Same thing.
At a wholesale place, I believe it was named Gambler's RV in Quartzsite, Arizona. It's $30. That's why it looked different.
Yeah.
I understand. All right. Hold on a second. I'll let you. It's kind of tricky. And you were auto technician?
Yes.
Mr. Jeff?
Now we're just going to put this right up in there.
All right, so we'll push right on in. All right, I'll put the screws back in.
What about Teflon here? Do you know Teflon?
Nope.
I just have a fear of leaks. Now, I see I've got a new flange. Or is this a wax? It's not a wax seal.
It's like your wax seal in a house. This is just your toilet flange right here. We're going to put a new toilet flange on before we put the new seat or new toilet back in.
Okay. Got the babies outside. A little bit cool out here, so I put a towel. It's about, what do you say, 55 degrees out here, 60? Just a touch cool. So the wolf pack says hello. Everybody wants to see them.
There's a right way and a wrong way to put those on there, so.
All right.
Just like you did, yep.
It looks different.
This part here is going to go down.
I understand, but it just looks different. Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
Now all this stuff here belongs to my traveling friend Luke. He's doing a remodel of the inside of his van.
Now another thing, when we set this down on there, being that's that new flange in there, the base, sometimes you really have to push hard on this to get your nuts on, because you got to squish that new gasket down tight.
To seal.
Now, all right, so just getting it lined up. Here we go. We were having trouble getting the flange to sit on it right. So instead of putting the new flange on the toilet pipe in the floor, we decided to put it on the bottom of the toilet first instead. I don't think those were the right terms, Jeff.
I think you're close enough.
All right.
And then to line it up, it's just a matter of feeling for the hole down here.
I tell you what, had to get Mr. Jeff in here to help me. I couldn't get the flange to set. And after about 5 minutes of cursing and both of us learning new four-letter words from each other, it set. So now I'm going to retighten the water supply back here and put on the toilet bolts. Just finger tight?
Yes. To get it to where it's snug.
Okay. I don't want any more leaks, but I don't want to crack it either. And I'm assuming when you pull these nuts down equally at the same time.
Yes, back and forth.
Back and forth from side to side. Feels like the rear is higher than the front of the RV. All right, I got both sides pretty much equal, and Mr. Jeff was telling me if I just sit on the toilet, my weight would crush the new flange into shape.
Compress it down.
Kind of makes me think of, I'm going to show myself sitting on my toilet in my RV. And I absolutely do. I have to open the door and sit sideways when I use it. So as I sit on the toilet, pressing it down, Mr. Jeff came on either side and used his fingers and tightened down the nuts on each side, getting it equal. Now I'll be able to take the wrench and tighten it up fully. Okay, Mr. Jeff, we got the toilet bolts tight.
Right.
Now, you were telling me that after I use it for a couple weeks or a couple times, go back and reach.
It wouldn't, just to retighten it again, just to make sure it's good and snug, because that gasket's still going to compress a little bit, possibly.
Over time. Okay. And then, of course, make sure to go back and check for leaks, make sure everything's tight.
Once we turn the water back on.
And the new valve's good.
Yes.
And there's my potty for the whole world to see. Got air. All right, time will tell.
Now reach behind and see if we got any leaks.
Check for water back here. It's only one place it could leak. And that's where it was leaking from, was above this flange here, this screw-on flange. Seems tight to me. I don't feel anything. I'll let you check. Think we got
all
it?
All good.
All right. Mr. Jeff, I can't thank you enough for helping me.
Anytime.
I just wasn't quite brave enough to do it by myself. And when this guy offered to do it, it was just a real blessing. And that's how the RV community is. That's what I've seen out here. Everybody helping everybody. And you're one of the good guys.
But especially when you get to help out a celebrity like Kevin.
What a guy.
I'll tell you what, he rocks.
All right, everybody. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye. I'd like to thank everybody for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. I also want to take the time to let everyone know that watches my videos that I now have a Patreon account. So any of you guys that would like to invest anything back into my channel, even if it's $1 a month or $5 a month, now you can. My videos will always be free, but if you did enjoy it and you would like to invest back into Camper Van Kevin, you can now do so at www.patreon.com/campervankevin. The address is down below. Thanks again. Bye-bye.